isn't it? Take whatever you want underneath, by all means. So now on comes the field goal unit, and wow, this is no ordinary try here. This will be from 56 yards out. And this is off target to the left, didn't get there anyway. It's no good, and this will remain a 2-touchdown game. Thought that might be the goose egg breaker, still stuck on zero.
Yeah, this is still a tight game too. We gotta keep that in mind because that miss there, you hang your head, you let it affect you the next time you go out there, then you've really hurt your ball club. Get yourself together, you might get another opportunity, and they're gonna count on you to put it through the post.
It's a pickup of four, and it'll bring up second down. Stevenson, and he'll get it down here to the 43. 87 yards for him on the ground now, as he has been terrific here this afternoon.
No surprise to see Stevenson making that type of a play. People know him well. Unsurprised to see him over 1,000 yards this past season. He's a bruiser who was also fourth among backs with 69 catches. He can do it all in the New England offense.
From the gun, it's Stevenson. And he's going to be down at the 35, gain of 7.
Well, you certainly have to give a little credit here because they're playing this game now at their pace. This is ball control football, sustained runs, taking their time, and making it work.
From the 35 on second down, Jones, he's going to let this go. Back of the end zone, and that will be incomplete. Trying to dial up the long one way out there, but it'll be third down.
Well, they took their shot. That one was kind of up for grabs that time. And you've got to be careful defensively not to make contact too early. But that was textbook right there to get in tight and force the incompletion.
Now, meanwhile, the final play here is incomplete, and that's going to take us to the end of the third quarter of play. We have played three quarters. You are watching the NFL on EA Sports. Back now here at MetLife Stadium. We get set for the fourth quarter. Patriots have the lead. They also have the football. And with things looking pretty good on the scoreboard, they're going to keep the offense out there and go for it here on fourth. Looking to throw. Jones. He's got his man. It's Kendrick Bourne. And he is going to pick up a Patriots first down as he's brought to the ground after a gain of 7, 5 more than he needed on 4th and 2. Now a handoff, Stevenson. And he'll go down right on the edge of the red zone following a pickup of about 7 or 8.
Oh, that's one to warm the hearts of all those old school football players, isn't it? Tough, hard, gritty run, got behind his pads, bowled over a few people. Look at that one, right up the gut.
So up through three quarters, no reason to lighten up now. Stevenson gets it again on second down. And he's brought down just outside of the 10 at the 11. 9 yards to pick up there, and it's a first down.
I think there's a fatigue factor that's kicking in defensively. You know the will is still strong, but I think the offense is starting to bend it just a little bit, don't you?
Yeah, absolutely. It's looked that way. We'll see if they can continue this already strong drive. Now a first and 10 at the 11. Now a run with Stevenson. And here he'll get it down to the 7. 5 yards on the carry. Good pickup on first down. From the 7, it's 2nd and 5. And they run with Stevenson. And he's dropped just before the line to gain. 4-yard pickup leaves him with 3rd and 1.
They're pretty good spot right now with a convincing lead. I think this is where they put on the boxing gloves, start to try and pound them into submission.
And the offensive line, they've controlled. And he is in. Touchdown, New England. From Ramondre Stevenson. His second touchdown of the game, his third of the year. And the Patriots are looking to make it two straight as they add on to this fourth quarter lead. On third down, it's short and everything well executed. He not only gets the first down, Charles, he gets the touchdown as well.
And you see the defense commit to the run so often in these situations. There's always that little bit of hesitancy, isn't there, partner? Thinking that they may play action here. They took advantage of that hesitancy and found their way into the end zone with a running play.
Extra point by Ryland, up and good. And it's now 21 to nothing. Ryland now following the touchdown, back out to kick it away. On the return from his end zone, Malik Taylor. And he'll be stopped right around where he would have been had he gone down to a knee, maybe a yard shy of there at the 24. The New York set to take the field. Well, it's been a struggle so far for this offense, Charles. It's not only that they haven't been able to put the points up, but really stringing yards together has been a real issue for them in this one.
I'm so glad you brought up the yardage, because I was thinking to myself, we've seen a lot of NFL games, and we've seen our share of lopsided contests, but in almost all of them, both offenses have put up at least 200 yards in a game, but not in this one. This has been a display of offense that, frankly, I think the two of us have watched from behind our hands, trying to spread our fingers wide enough to actually see the result.
He'll lose a yard there, and it's second and 11.
I think this offense, specifically this running game, they're going to have to find a way to turn the page, because they haven't found a way to run it effectively thus far, and it's cost them.
Of a yard there to start out. That leads to a second and 11. Now Rodgers throwing quickly to Wilson. And he's brought down, getting this one up to about the 35. Second catch for him today, and it'll wind up a first down. A three-score game here late. You can probably rule out the comeback, but certainly some kind of a moral victory to be had if they can get a few more points to close things out. And to that end, a nice pass play there to push things downfield.
Yeah, and we know in this league, a loss is a loss, and no one wants anything to count as a moral victory or, boy, something that feels a little...
And that is going to be pulled in one-handed. Wow. Big yardage that time for the Jets. And even 50 yards.
And there's not a quarterback in the league that will ever complain about having small receivers like a Tyreek Hill or a Cooper Kupp who can find a seam, have good vision, and get open. But when you're throwing downfield like this, you want a big, tall receiver who can go above the rim, or if you're a volleyball fan, above the net and get it.
So after the big play, look at this, all the way down at the 15 now on first and 10. Out of the gun, they run with Carter. And now they're inside the 10 as he's brought down at the 9. Give him 5 on the carry there, and it'll be second down. Now it's Rodgers. Taken down, trying to do a little too much, getting outside of the pocket, and it results in a sack. Dietrich Wise Jr. getting him once again, his third sack of the afternoon.
We all know he's one of the better quarterbacks in the league, but definitely not today. His team trailing by multiple touchdowns and a late sack, just a parting gift from the defense for him to take back to the locker room with him.
The offense on third down, they've only converted once in 4 tries. This is third and 14. To throw is Rodgers. He completes it to Wilson. And all the way down inside the 5 to the 4. They're able to convert on third down, and that sets up a first and goal. Off offense for them has been at a premium. You wonder where plays like that have been all game long.
They're thinking the exact same thing themselves, but they're also looking forward now, because now these plays are really for next week, trying to get some momentum going.
To throw. And he's gonna be dropped back at the 15-yard line. Matt Judon, he's the one to get him, and that is sack number 7 for him on the year.
Guys with his talent in the pocket aren't supposed to be getting hit like this, and you know an intense conversation with the offensive line is going to occur after this one. Might not be from him, but the offensive line coach will have plenty to say about this game.
Just 2 minutes remaining here in the fourth quarter of what has been a one-sided affair. So it's Jets football as we get you reset here. Got to assume this defense will be charging again here. It's second and 15. Rodgers now to throw. Under pressure, they got him again. This defense has not surrendered a touchdown yet. You better believe they're determined not to here on third and goal. That's going to be caught. A big play, but still not enough. Leads to a fourth and goal. Now Rodgers got to have this one. And this will be caught in the end zone. Touchdown, Jets. Tyler Conklin, a 2-yard touchdown grab. And the Jets are finally on the board here in the fourth quarter.
I'm not sure win-win is the proper term here, but it certainly felt like it. They had the touchdown they needed, but if I'm on the defensive side of the ball, okay, you got the touchdown, but it sure took you a long time.
Yeah, because offensively, though, you're probably hoping for a 1-5 play drive. That one ate up a little more time than they were hoping.
You're exactly right, and if you have that 1-5 play drive, you actually build up momentum and even more hope. When they had to slog their way downfield, they got the touchdown, but it's almost like,
It doesn't feel right.
Exactly.
Now Greg Zuerlein on for the extra point. It's up, it's good, and that'll cut the lead to 21-7. A 10-play drive that time, and it ends with a Jet touchdown. So two scores down, time definitely not an ally, but here comes the onside kick. And this is secured by the Patriots. They knew they needed a miracle. They had to have that onside kick. They didn't get it.
Well, as we knew, even before they put the toe to the leather on that one, their chances of getting that done, slim and none. And I do believe we saw Slim just leave the door, didn't we?
We did indeed. I think we're down to none. New England's offense set to go. And a few kneel downs should just about do it. Now, defensively, they do have all three timeouts, but very little reason to use them at this point. Looks like he'll throw here. And he is going to have the first down. And that might not officially end it, but for all intents and purposes, they should be able to run it down from here. Back to throw. Jones. And that's going to be incomplete.
Well, they had that one snipped out defensively. That's a tough one to connect on when you've got multiple defenders in the area, and it winds up incomplete.
An incomplete pass leads to second and 10 from the 25. Looking to throw. Jones. Ball hit as he throws there, incomplete.
Well, that's a good piece of quarterbacking right there because he certainly felt the pressure coming. The alternative, getting sacked for the first time. He didn't like that option at all. Did a nice job saving yardage by throwing that one away.
Meanwhile, on third down, they take a shot at the end zone, but it's incomplete.
From a defensive perspective, they had exactly what you want anytime they want to throw the football. There was pressure on the quarterback. They were getting after him, and they tightened down on the receivers and forced the incompletion.
On now, the rookie fourth-round pick, Chad Ryland, for the Patriot field goal. This to make it a three-score game late. And his kick here is good. And that will extend their lead even further. So with that, you figure, yeah, this game's pretty much out of reach at this point.
Yeah, it's going to take a heck of a comeback to come from three scores down. But don't change that channel. Don't go away. Miracles can happen, and you want to be here in case it does.
You're a company man.
Now, aren't I, though?
So after the field goal, Ryland back out as he'll send this one away. And he won't quite make it to the 25. The New York set to take the field. They're down big here late. I don't know. You just one last drive here for pride.
Some people like to do that. I remember playing for a guy once. We were down huge. And someone said, "Coach, what do you want to call?" He just waved a hand like, "Who cares? Let's
make
get out of here and do something some other time." But some teams like to do something at the end to feel a little bit better
as they continue
to move forward.
Yeah, probably just want to put this one behind them. And they're able to get this one across the 35. Now the Jets going to use the second of their three timeouts as he'll stop it with 27 seconds showing on the clock. Well, those are the types of plays they probably wish they had made more of in the first three quarters. And this deficit going to be tough to overcome here in the fourth. But a nice first down and a pickup on that throw.
Yeah, and this is where as coaches, you're looking for effort and execution even though the score.
And this is going to be intercepted. Picked up by Jonathan Jones. And the Patriots are going to get the football back at their own 17. All smiles and high fives on that defensive sideline. That interception will cap off what was truly a tremendous performance.
Yeah, if you can hold a team to 7 points in the NFL, that's the kind of day that you feel really good about. Now, I do know a few guys are going to think to themselves, held them to seven. If we'd made one more play, could have had our shutout.
Jones on first and 10. And he'll let this go deep for Bourne. Oh, that's into double coverage and intercepted. And the Jets will take over possession here. Look at the 44. Boy, that one was in the air for an agonizingly long time.
Just begging to be picked off, wasn't it? It's one thing if you're throwing a ball like that, trying to throw someone open or lead them into an area. But that ball needed to be thrown with a lot more conviction. As a result, it's an easy interception.
Jets offense coming up now to start their next drive. They have a little bit of time left here, but this one not going to go their way.
And this is where, in this situation for me.
All right, rifles one, and that's going to be intercepted. It's Kyler Duggar who picks it. Empty move. And a huge return as he'll take this one all the way down inside the 30-yard line. So that changes things. You get the interception, and then to boot, a good return tacked on.
And really, it was down to him versus the quarterback on the return, and that's one you would think the defender would win. But a nice job there of seeing the play all the way to the end and making the tackle by the QB.
They go back to the air here after the INT on the last drive. Going to throw deep for the end zone. So this will wind up a victory for the New England Patriots. And it was their defense that really paved the way to this victory as they allowed the one touchdown. And that was all she wrote.
Almost want to do the defense chant right now, right? Defense with a couple of claps in there, but no one wants to hear that from me. Let's just talk about how they got it done, though. When you take care of every aspect of the game, shut down the run, control the airways, right? Make sure the quarterback is harassed. This type of performance you get. They can't fashion together any offense, no consistency, and they just took control.
So for New England, it's back-to-back victories now after the Week 1 defeat as they move to 2-1. And they'll get another road test next week as they head to Big D to take on the Cowboys. Meanwhile, for the Jets, they'll fall to 1-2. And they'll get a chance to redeem themselves at home next week. So that'll do it for my partner, Charles Davis, and the best darn crew in the industry. I'm Brandon Gott. This has been a presentation of the NFL on EA Sports. With that, we sign off from MetLife Stadium.